What's up guys, my name is Mario and on this video we're going to take a look at the Samsung Dex Station. We're going to go over what a Dex Station offers, the design, how it works, so make sure to stick around. If you're new to this channel, consider subscribing for a weekly tech video. You're probably wondering what is a Dex Station and what does it do for me. First of all, let me get started by saying that as the release of this video, the Dex Station is only compatible with the Samsung Galaxy Note 8, the Samsung Galaxy S8 and the S8 Plus. If you're lucky to own one of these phones, you will be able to turn your mobile phone into a desktop computer. Before we move into the user functionality, let's take a look at the physical design. Starting from the back, the Dex Station will offer two USB ports that will allow you to connect an external device like a mouse or a keyboard. It will also come with an Ethernet port in case you want to connect using the Ethernet cable for faster speeds. Also, it will come with an HDMI port to connect to an external monitor or your TV. Towards the end, you'll have a Type-C port to connect to the power supply. By the way, the Type-C and the wall charger come already with the Dex Station. Moving to the top, it will have a pretty cool sliding cover, which will work for easy storage. The built-in fan will help you keep the phone cool. The design will allow the phone to stay up at a viewing angle while the phone lines up with the Type-C input located on the bottom, which will connect your phone to the Dex Station and it will also keep it charged up. When you dock the phone to the Dex Station, it will automatically launch the interface. On the start of the screen, it will prompt you for the security access if any are set up on the mobile device. You can still use the finger reader sensor, but it is not convenient having to reach out to the back of the phone without disconnecting the phone from the Dex Station. Once you're in, if you look in the bottom of the left-hand side, you can find the Apps button, the Recent button, and the Home button. In the bottom right-hand side, you will find the notification bar and the miscellaneous settings as you will see on the top of your mobile device. Moving into the user's functionality, the Dex Station will allow you to launch your apps on a bigger screen. Using the keyboard and mouse, this will allow you to increase your productivity if you need to surf the internet, work on multiple documents at the same time, or even remotely access your home computer. You will be able to have multiple applications open and display at the same time on the screen. When it comes to sound, you will be listening to the phone speaker or the display itself if it has a speaker or audio output. You can also connect to Bluetooth speakers or headphones. You won't be able to connect the audio using the audio jack as the Dex Station will be blocking the audio output from the phone. It will not allow you to play any advanced games as the performance of the Dex Station is limited to the performance of your phone. In fact, even many of the mobile games won't be compatible, but many of the apps that you currently have installed should be compatible and work pretty good. Overall, it works good and is responsive. I'm able to launch multiple applications and navigate with no issues. That doesn't mean you should expect the same performance as when you do when you're using the phone. I do notice a lag if I start multitasking heavily. If I try to open many applications at the same time and start switching from one to another, I can see an impact on the performance. When it comes to compatibility, there's some apps that work better than others. Some apps I'm able to open in full screen or change the viewing angle and access all the features, while other apps are limited. When you open an app, you will get a message letting you know if the app is compatible or if some of the features are limited. I'm pretty sure that many of the apps will continue to get updates for better compatibility, especially if Samsung continues to push the Dex Station in the future phones. On the bright side, it offers apps for Dex. This is similar to the Play Store, but it is only dedicated to apps that are compatible with the Dex Station. At the moment, there's only a few apps that are available in the apps for Dex, but hopefully the list will continue to grow as time goes by. The purpose of this video is not to do a full review of the apps, but if that is something that you're interested in, make sure to subscribe and check out my other videos as I plan to do a detailed review about it. I can tell you that I find it productive reading, replying to emails, texts, and comments on my YouTube videos, but I'm more interested in knowing what your thoughts on the Dex Station are or if there's anything specific that you would like to see on a future video. Make sure to leave your questions, concerns, opinions in the comment section below. Thank you for watching and don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel for a weekly tech video. I'll see you on the next one.